In the fragmented Linux space, you will often run into applications in the form of AppImage files. This video will help you understand all the important aspects of using AppImage applications. From running AppImages to adding desktop integrations, you will learn tips that will make your experience with AppImages a lot better. App images are single executable files, somewhat like those .exe files in Windows. They often have all the necessary dependencies packed in. And here's the thing, you don't need to install an application with AppImage. You simply run it. To run a file in Linux, you need to ensure that the file has executable permission. You can use GUI or terminal and enable execute permission on the AppImage. Once it is executable, double click on it to run it. This should work on most Linux distributions, except in Ubuntu, because AppImage depends on the libfuse version 2 library, and Ubuntu now provides libfuse version 3. That's why you need to install the required version of libfuse library first, and once you have that, you can double click on the AppImage file and it should run fine. Quick tip here. If the downloaded AppImage file does not run the application despite having execute permission and libfuse 2 installed, it is possible that the AppImage is not properly packaged for your system. You can find that out by running the AppImage from the terminal. Run it like you run a shell script. Observe the output. If you see errors, then it is the problem with the AppImage application. You can file a bug report with the developer and look for an alternative package, because there's little you can do here. Remember, AppImage applications are single files. If you want to use them, you have to keep this file. You cannot delete it like you delete the deb or RPM files after installing the software from them. Now, you can keep them anywhere on the system and they can be anywhere, but I prefer keeping them together in a dedicated folder which can be named anything. This way, I won't accidentally delete them while cleaning up the downloads folder, which has all kinds of junk. One major problem with AppImage application is that they don't have desktop integration by default, which means that you cannot find the AppImage applications in the system menu. While some AppImage ask you to enable system integration, but that's really rare, and that's a major drawback. But there's always a way in Linux. Here, you can use third-party tools to enjoy this feature. For years, I used AppImage Launcher tool in Ubuntu that helped with desktop integration. With AppImage Launcher installed, each time you run a new AppImage app, it asks you for desktop integration. Now, the problem is that this tool has not seen a new release in several years, but it still works if you get the latest one from its release base. Of course, you don't need to rely on an unmaintained app to get AppImages in system menu. There is a much better option in the form of gear lever. It's a Flatpak application, so you need to ensure that you have Flatpak support enabled first. And that's the irony of fragmented Linux ecosystem. To get a better AppImage experience, you need to use Flatpak, a different packaging system. Anyway, install Gear Lever Flatpak app and run it. Gear Lever is an excellent tool and offers several features. For the start, you can set up the location for AppImages, which will be typically saved in AppImages folder in your home directory. You can choose to set Gear Lever as the default for running AppImage applications. You can even drag and drop AppImages to Gear Lever. It will ask you to unlock it, just a feature to remind you to only use AppImages from legit sources. You must click Move to the App menu button to let Gear Lever integrate the app into the system. You will see that it has moved the AppImage file to the dedicated folder and even created icons for it. The applications now can be found in the system menu like other regular apps. That's the beauty of Gear Lever. But it doesn't end here. Gear Lever also helps you when you want to use two versions of the same application. In addition, GearLiver also has features to handle updates on existing app images. Now, some app images are packaged properly and GearLiver can automatically extract the repository information from where it will check for any new release of the applications. But not all app image applications are packaged nicely. And if GearLiver does not see the repository information, you can manually add one. Of course, you need to do some fact finding first to get the repository details yourself. Mostly, you can get it from the application's official webpage, where the GitHub repository or GitLab repositories are usually listed. Another handy application for handling AppImage application is AppImage Pool. It is built on Flutter and it is sort of like a software center, but for AppImage applications. You can install it from its GitHub repo in Flatpak or AppImage format. I am going with AppImage here. Here is what it looks like. And as you can see, you can browse through the categories of applications and search for them and install them. AppImage Pool is not without problems, as it didn't work as expected when KSnip was installed. Only after I restarted it, it showed the newly installed KSnip in the installed sections. Once you are here, clicking on the check mark integrates the application with the system. And thus, you can now run the application from the system menu. And that's where I noticed another bug, as it did not show the icons for the installed applications. Apparently, it is a known bug that has not been fixed yet. Although it is a promising application as it lets you integrate and disintegrate app images easily, along with giving an app store-like feel, but the bugs spoil the experience here. I advise sticking with GearLiver for the moment. Now, this section is purely for terminal dwellers, people who like to do it in the terminal. Remember the AppImage launcher I talked about earlier? It comes with a CLI version too. But since it has not seen updates, let's see newer options. I prefer AppMan for this purpose. There is an official script to install it. AppMan won't work properly if you already have AppImage launcher installed. So uninstall if it has been installed previously and reboot your system. Once you have taken care of that, the first time you run it, you should run the help page because it will also help you enable shell completion. Now, AppImage works on a database of app images that you can find on its website. So you install an AppImage application by searching for it with AppMan and then installing it using the name which you found in the search. AppMan installs each app image into its own folder in the application folder in the home directory. Here, you can find the update and remove scripts as well. There are more options here. You can see more details on an app with the info option. You can also downgrade an already installed app image application if needed. And of course, you can update an installed app image application if there is an update available in the database. Again, all this is managed by a third-party community-level stuff, and not everyone should be comfortable with it. There are a few more tools you can use for app image management. There is JAP for command line ninjas, and there's BAH, which is a combined package manager for app images, Flatpak, Snaps, etc. You learn to install app image applications with required libraries, explore tools that can help you use them in a better way, and also learn where you can find app image applications. Now, you probably already knew a few things here, and maybe you learned something new. So let me know in the comments if you learned something new about app images in this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Keep on using Linux. Stay awesome. Bye-bye.